This is going to be the Hoover A3060's last wash before going into storage for a little while to have a little rest. So we're going to be doing a load of Woollens on program E and using it with a half spin option or slow spin to make that minimum iron 50. We're going to test out if the machine works on the slow spin on this. So keep yourselves tuned in, watch in HD because you are watching Florence Ballard A3060, the channel made in honour of the original Supreme Florence Ballard, the Shirelles and Hoover's first 1100rpm automatic, the A3060 Electronic 1100. Loading her up. So I've got a scarf, heavy woolen jumper, thinner one, and a little button-up fleece or cardigan. So not really a bulky load, just some everyday woolens. Princess likes that. I normally drop this in the door seal, but I'm going to put it under in the drum. So for detergent, I'm going to be using an old brand of mine, Formal Non-Bio. Recently been giving this a go, going to do a review on it, and I'm actually very impressed. So it's got a very like turquoisey blue colour to it, and blue specks in there. So I'm going to pop some of that in. Is actually the correct dosage for small load. So that's about 40 mil that I put in. That's about nearly 60 mil that I put in. Me, hard water, normal soiling, 105, so I need to do an extra 40 for that. So I now go by the dosage of what it actually tells you to do. For hard water, or that's quite a lot to put in, but hey, that's what it's telling me to do for normal soiling. And we're using, to complete the set, Dowsy Summer Sun Fabric Conditioner. Of course, we know when to add that in. So we're going to select Program E, which is normally 40 degrees Celsius non-fast coloureds. But to make it minimum iron 50, we are going to select the slow spin. Without further ado, we can start.
Enjoy.
And which washer 2007 are trying to figure out is how is the machine doing a 50 degree cycle with literally just the slow spin being enabled.
We're getting quite salty there. That's because it's designed to work at higher temperatures.
Interesting to know if this does actually reach 50 and see if the machine does that phenomenon at the end where she'll do a fast spin regardless. Heating stage. Mm-hmm.
dilution routes. So, the door glass got a faulty, but I know that the water temperature possibly would have been about 45 in there. Form has got really, really salty there. Distribution drain. We'll rip up a good few suns there. First intermediate spin. Distribute. don't know if I mentioned, I put new wheels on this machine. For like caster wheel, but just took the wheel out and put it on the existing lug. Machine is easier to move, sits level for once, although it does move about a little more than the Carver. If you've got that Hoover character again.
You can see how clear the rinse water is already, and that's just from one spin. Conditioner in now, so when I normally add it, just after the machine's finished filling for the second rinse. And that's that. There you go.
Second intermediate spin. Salt's coming out of the machine because he beats the devil out of it at the last minute. Smooth. That creaking sound here is just the machine on the wheels. Yeah, it's very unbalanced, that is. Thank you. don't it? Let's see what the final spin does. Pretty damn clear. Final spin, let's see what happens. There we go, she's made a point clear. I did bet that one of the spins was going to be really unbalanced. Right, now let's see what happens. Will the machine do 500 or should it just do 1100? The buttons on my sweat, my jumper for doing that. Right, here we go. Well, she's decided she's going to be on balance. Let's see. She should start at 500 and we'll just see if the machine does 500 for the whole time or what. Might be balanced, I think. Any focus on this. Mm-hmm.
When did 800 mean slow spin?
Thank you. actually.
Wow. Well, not to complain, very dry woolens have come out of that. And what I just do is pull the drum, seal up a bit, as much water drain off as possible.
I just use basically tissues to clean up the door seal and dry it off.
Because now she's got to go in storage, so although I might do one very last wash in the machine before, but I just do this to make sure there's all, see, there's all bits of the scuff in there. Okay. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed the time we've had with the Hoover A3060. You nearly said me at that. Definitely had quite a lot of washes, including washing involved in here as well. We are going to be bringing the Cassata by Hotpoint WM63 in, I don't know when, a couple of days maybe. We'll see, maybe tomorrow or Thursday night I'll bring her in. And then after that, yes, we just resume with that machine. So, and that's pretty much what we've got to look forward to. I've got a couple of iron demonstrations I can do, but aside from that, that'll be really it. So I hope you all enjoyed this, and thank you to all those who have enjoyed this machine being on the channel. As I said, this machine is the trademark of my channel, and one of the main reasons I made my channel. So, you know, it's good to keep the machine going, but she deserves a well-earned rest now. You know, can't obviously keep the machine running too long. With a Cassata, we can keep that running for a bit longer. But what I'll do is probably weekly swaps leading up to Christmas. So up to Christmas, all machines will get a chance to have been in here dressed up with tinsel and whatnot on. I'll probably put bells on the A3060, so when the machine shakes about, they ring. So anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to keep it supreme and go with the flow.